Sports Network's live coverage of Bethel Volleyball. I'm Justin Brown alongside my co-host Andrew Boyer. Tonight, the Pilots take on
Goshen College in another Crossroads League matchup. Standings, currently we have Bethel in 7th place in the Crossroads as they are 5-8 in conference. Goshen is one step behind them, ranked 8th in the conference at 5-9. And Boyer, what are some key players we've seen this season that kind of got the Pilots to where they are in this season?
Definitely. And also, this is a big matchup because Goshen is, like you said, one behind in the top 8 go to the Crossroads League tournament. And they're going to need great performances from these people. Kristen Mitchell, she leads the team in digs, 519 this season. And Cassandra Williams in blocks. That's going to be really helpful on the defensive side. But let's not forget senior, and they're honoring her tonight. It's senior night. Zoe Wolfenbarger, 281 kills this season. And she plans to add maybe 15, 20 more in this one. She is outstanding, and we're going to be calling her name a lot. And also, Sammy Leach coming up, leads the team in assists. She is very good.
And those are some key leaders we're going to be looking at tonight for this matchup. As Boyer mentioned, it is senior night for the Pilots, so we'll be honoring both Zoe Wolfenbarger and Amanda Brinkman, the seniors, for tonight. We got some balloons, we got some banners. They just finished honoring them, so it should be a huge game here for those seniors. And as Boyer did mention, this is a huge game for both teams, as the top 8 in the Crossroads will advance to the tournament, and top 4 get that home court advantage. As Bethel is number 7, Goshen is number 8. This is a huge game for both teams. It should be a solid matchup tonight.
Definitely, and Bethel also involved in a 3-way tie with Huntington and Grace as well. All at 5-8, so a win tonight really sets the tone. It gets them up closer and closer to that top 4 spot so they can have a home game in the Crossroads League tournament.
Lisa Rodriguez with the serve here for the Maple Leafs. Big hit there from Kristen Mitchell for the Pilots. It's going to be a free ball here for the Pilots. Set comes in there for our senior, Zoe. Good dig there from the Maple Leaf side. Touched over the net there. That's a mistake there from the Pilot side. Free ball going over the net, killed by the Maple Leafs.
Good rally there starting out. Pilots really need to set the tone. It's going to be very important. That first set is always very important.
Rodriguez with another serve here. Zoe with the ball over the net. Handled well with by the Maple Leafs. Back over the net for them. Good dig there by Katie. Called out there by number 4, Lisa Rodriguez, the server for the Maple Leafs. Pushed just wide there from the Pilot side as the Maple Leafs now go up 2-0 in this game number 1. Short set over the top there for number 14, Cassandra Williams. Coming up huge there for the Pilots, getting the first points on the board as we have senior Amanda Brinkman onto the court for the first time tonight.
Wolfenbarger and Brinkman were honored before the game. A very nice ceremony for senior night. See how they play tonight.
Big hit there from the freshman for Goshen. Senior, another hit over the top there. Handled well with by the Maple Leaf side. Touch there, big block by the Pilots. Well done there. This is going to be a free ball coming here for the Pilots. Set coming in, big hit there from Cassandra. Good block there by the freshman for the Maple Leafs. That's number 9, Darian Moss, the freshman out of Bristol, Indiana, 6'1". That's a big body there, putting up a huge block for the Goshen side there. Now up 3-1 as Christy Schwarzenbrugger served there for the Maple Leafs. Another big block there from the Goshen side. Right time, right place, well done there by the Maple Leafs.
The ball looked like it hit a brick wall, just bounced right back at him.
Well done there from Goshen side as we have number 10, Christy, once again with the serve. Good service at the top there, dig by Aaron Carlos. Ball coming here for Cassandra, finding the open spot. That's going to be called against number 9. I'm not sure what the call is there, Boyer, but that's going to be a point for the Pilots either way.
Yep, score is now 4-2 in favor of Goshen. The Pilots are chipping away at it.
Aaron Carlos now with the serve for your Pilots. Down by 2 in game number 1. Good service over the top. Aaron does lead the team in aces. Big block there from the senior Amanda Brinkman. She's going to have a huge night here with that senior leadership we mentioned so much before. Zoe and Amanda, both leaders on this team. This is their last home game as seniors. needed to come up huge here tonight. Unfortunate mistake there by Aaron Carlos. That's a serve in the net. Point for Goshen. And Boyer, in the games we've called before, we've mentioned not making the mistakes. And I feel like the Pilots keep making these simple mistakes that leading to them not putting these games away.
Definitely those fundamental errors come back to bite them more often than any team would like to see. So if they can cut down on them, you've shown that they are very deadly. Wolfenbarger able to get it over there.
Free ball here coming for Goshen over the net there. Finding the open spot there in the Bethel defense. That's unfortunate there for the Pilot side as Goshen has found that open spot and put it away. We now have number 7, McKinnon Tracy, the sophomore for Goshen with the serve as they are now up 6-3 in game number 1. Service over the net there. Set for Zoe. A little miscommunication there. Unfortunate as it is a free ball now for Goshen. Big hit. Huge block there from Haley Brown for the Pilots. Well done there on the Pilots defense. There we go. Zoe Wolfenbarger, the senior, coming up huge with a block there for the Pilots. Now they are down 2 as the senior leader goes up to serve.
She had that one-on-one matchup right at the net, and she came out on top. Very well done by Vegas.
Vegas with the serve. Over the net. Well done there. Ball coming over the top there for Goshen. Cheeky touch there. Touch over the net there by Peyton Anderson. Unfortunately, not enough to put it away. We've seen this before. Peyton Anderson really likes the cheeky touch over the net, kind of that short set. We'll see how that can play out tonight in this senior matchup.
Definitely. She does very well picking her spots and keep catching the defense off guard, getting that little cheeky touch right over the net.
Allie Rohr now with the serve for Goshen.
There that it is.
We mentioned it, and she delivers. Here it is, Peyton Anderson with that short set over the net. And we've talked about this before. Sometimes it's not the huge hits that get it done. It's those short sets right over the net, finding the open spot. We mentioned it. Peyton delivers. Well done there from Peyton Anderson. We now have Katie Easter to serve here for the Pilots.
It's almost like we called it or something.
It's almost like we called it, Boar, helping the Pilots out a little bit.
Maybe we have a future in this business.
Maybe we could. I don't know. We'll see as the Pilots are now down by 2. Katie with the serve. Goshen now with the hit there. Blocked there by the Pilots. Well done there from Haley and Peyton. Krista Mitchell in the net. Unfortunate. Zoe with the backcourt hit. Well done there from the senior. Zoe Wolfenberger coming from the back line. Hitting that one over the net. Too much for Goshen to deal with. Down by 1.
That was just way too much to handle. As the deficit is only 1 for Bethel now.
Good service from Katie. A little miscommunication there on the Goshen side. We now have ourselves a tied ball game. And Bora, we talked about before also, the Pilots got to have fun. And it seems like they're definitely enjoying this game so far.
Definitely. They're playing as a team. They're playing as one cohesive unit right now. And it's really showing it's paying off.
No service from Katie. Awkward handle there from the Goshen side. This is going to be a free ball for the Pilots. And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Touch over the Pilots. That's out of bounds off the Goshen hand. Pilots now on top in game number 1.
See if they can keep this momentum rolling. Maybe take home this set.
Good service there from Katie Easter. Good touch there. Unfortunate for Zoe there as it is now tied 8-8. And Bora, you mentioned it'd be huge for them to win this first set. Statistically, once again, we look at this stat. When the Bethel Pilots lose the first set, they are 0-13.
That is not a good set to look. A good stat to look at. Really should get some fire under you.
Good dig there by Aaron Carlos, but I believe it was called a touch on the court now as Goshen is up by 1. Number 11, Aaron Strock, the sophomore out of Butler, Indiana, now to serve for the Maple Leafs. Service there into the net by Aaron. Another unforced error there for Goshen. We now see number 11, Bridget Downs, and number 14, Cassandra Williams, back onto the court. This is Bridget's first appearance now as she serves. Tied ball game 9-9 in game number 1. That's going to be a free ball there for the Pilots. Kristen Mitchell hitting that one over the top. Too much there for Goshen to handle as now our Pilots are up by 1. Once again in this game number 1.
You just look at it. Bridget Downs is a freshman, a true freshman. She does not play like it. She does very well as she gets an ace right there for the Pilots. score is now 9-11 in favor of Bethel.
Huge point there for Bethel. They're going up by two. See if they can get kind of a run going for the Pilot side. As you mentioned, Bridget being the true freshman, she's coming up huge here for a team with some consistent serves.
She does very well.
Great
at her
dig
job.
There by Zoe over the net. Well done there on the Pilot side. Pilot's now up by three. Bridget keeps the serve.
Showing some emotion there after that hit. They are feeling it right now as Bethel leads 12-9.
Service over by Bridget. Goshen kind of struggling, see if they can pull something away there. Good block there from the Pilot side. Number 13 there for Goshen. That's Lexa Magnuson finding the open spot, putting it away. That is a point they desperately needed there as Pilots were kind of pulling away with it. We now have number 22 for the Maple Leafs for the service.
And Carlos hits the deep. Krista Mitchell able to get it over for the Pilots. Well played there.
Krista Mitchell finding the gap in that Goshen defense, putting it away. Pilots up by three now as we have Peyton Anderson with the serve. Good touch there, unfortunate from Peyton, coming just off the outside of her arm now. Goshen within two as we are now 13-11 in game number one. See if Goshen can put something together now as we have number four once again, Lisa Rodriguez back to serve for the Maple Leafs. Service over the net, good dig there from Aaron Carlos. Gonna be a big hit here from Zoe. Blocked there by number one for Goshen. Short set, way to keep it alive there on the Goshen side. Into the net there by number one, Megan Gerke. Unfortunate play there on the Goshen side, but way to go there for the Pilots to stay composed.
Great job defensively there for Bethel. That front line was there right when they had to. They timed their jumps perfectly and the reward showed.
Some confusion on the court now. Not sure what the call is going to be. The referee is arguing there with Rochelle. It seems as though they're giving the point to Goshen. I'm not sure what the call is there, but there's definitely some frustration now on the Pilot side as it seemed like they earned that point, but we'll see what can go on there. And there we go, Cassandra Williams. And as they say, Boyer, ball don't lie. That's a point for the Pilots.
Definitely. Cassandra Williams took a look at the referee right there and said, we should have that point. She remedied that real quick. She got that point for him.
Service here now from Kristen, dealt well with by the Goshen side. Short set for the freshman there. Good block there from the Pilot. Zoe the senior, huge hit there from Zoe. She's loving it. She's having a good time, boy. We mentioned in our previous callings together, the key word typically in this game is momentum, and it's all on the Pilot side.
Definitely, they're playing loose, they're playing fast, and they're playing well together. That's what I like to see as they get that high serve. The front line play is really showing up for the Pilots, and that's what they need to keep continue doing to win this game.
Good dig there from Peyton Anderson. Aaron with the set. Zoe's got to go over the net. Short ball there, but ended up working in the Pilots' favor. Short set there for Cassandra. Puts it away. Pilots up 5-4. You can hear it now. See it on the bench. Girls are loving it. The fans are loving it. This is huge now, as it is the senior night we mentioned for these seniors. Amanda and Zoe both on the court now. Really wanted to put this one away. Good service there from Kristen.
Cassandra Williams is feeling it right now. She is playing very well as this first set goes on. See if she can translate into some consistency throughout the entire game.
Goshen now responded with a point of their own as they are now down by three, game number one. Service here from Christy Schwarzengruber. Set coming in here now for the senior Amanda, kept alive. Going to be a free point now for the Goshen side. Freshman, too much to deal with there for the Pilots. That's going to be a free ball. Set coming in here for Zoe. Zoe's feeling it. Another point there for Zoe Wolfenbarger. She's playing out of her mind tonight, Boyer.
She knows that senior night's all about her, and she is keeping the spotlight right on her with those hits.
That's
killing it tonight, pun intended.
She is killing it. Timeout now called for the Goshen Maple Leafs. That's a smart timeout in my eyes as the Pilots. It's been all Bethel in this first game. They're only up by four, but momentum is all in their favor. They're playing really well so far.
Definitely, and something Coach Wiegand told us earlier in the week, that Zoe especially and Amanda, for their senior leadership, they really kicked in about midway through the season. Things weren't going very well. They were in a bit of a rut, and Zoe said, hey, we're seniors. We don't get another opportunity at this next year. If we can't get together, we have to play for us, because we don't get to do this anymore. Like, we hang up our volleyball shoes at the end of this season. And they really responded to that well and really were able to come together and put some wins together. And it was all because of Zoe, who did very well. Coach Wiegand got them all rallied together like she always does, but Zoe and Amanda are senior leaders on this team, and they do very well at voicing that.
So we'll see what happens out of this timeout. Typically in a lot of these games, we'll see whoever comes out of the timeout stronger and with more emotion is going to do much better. Timeouts can kind of be killing that momentum, especially for the Pilots side. Now we'll see if they come out of that timeout with more momentum than they started with. Aaron Carlos now with the serve over the top. Well done there. Big hit there, dealt well with by Krista Mitchell. Short set for Haley Brown. Awkward mistiming there on the pilot side. A little miscommunication. Goshen now within three, as it is 17-14 for the Pilots. Service now here for Goshen. That's going to be number seven, McKinnon Tracy. Huge hit from the senior, Amanda Brinkman. That was incredible. That sounded like a cannon coming off her arm there, as now the Pilots are up by four.
Seems like Zoe and Amanda are really playing off of each other right now. They know it's their senior night. They're being honored tonight, and they are putting on a show for us.
And there's an ace for Zoe. You see it in the emotion on her face. That's a huge point there. And here we have another timeout for Goshen. It's going all Bethel's way in this first game. They're now only 6 points away from taking set number one, as it is 19-14. Boy, what does Goshen have to do now coming out of this timeout to kind of turn this thing around?
At this point, Goshen just has to kill Bethel's momentum. There are just, momentum is pretty much just two strong men pushing at each other. When one of them loses footing, when one of them slides in the dirt, they get pushed back a lot further. They need to find their footing and push back, because right now they're getting knocked right on their butt. So they need to come out swinging, come out hard, so they can chip away at this deficit right now, as they are down by five, because it is only 5 points. If you look at it, there's down 1 point, and then one more, and then one more. It's 1-0, now 1-1. And you just have to keep going at it until you can finally come out on top.
Couldn't agree more there, Boyer. The Goshen side really just has to think of it as 1 point at a time. They're down by five, which kind of seems like a big deficit, but in the grand scheme of things, it's just 1 point away. Keep going 1 point, 1 point, and then it's a tie ball game. So we'll see if the Pilots can keep that momentum alive here, as they are now within 6 points of taking game number one. They do go to 25 points for those of you that have not watched a lot of volleyball so far. But here we have the senior Zoe once again up to serve. Just got off of an ace. Not what the Goshen Maple Leafs wanted to see. We'll see what can happen now. Up by five, the senior Zoe with the serve. Dealt well with there by the Goshen side. Krista Mitchell with the dig. Set there from Peyton. Backcourt there for Zoe. Another kill for the senior leader. This is exactly what we wanted to see on senior night. She's loving it.
I am ready to see those after set stats on Zoe. She has been killing it. Her, along with Cassandra Williams, have been doing very well this opening set. And the consistency is there.
Short serve there from Zoe, mixing things up a little bit. That's going to be
point for the Pilots.
On number four, not sure if it is a carry or a double hit, but regardless, it's going to be a point for the Pilots side. They're now up 21-14. And this thing is pretty much getting close to being over there for Goshen. We'll see what can happen now. Good serve there once again from the senior. Big hit there. That's called in by the referee. It was close. Appeals on the Bethel side for it to be out, but I believe it was on the line. Subs coming in here now for Goshen. We'll see if they can turn this thing around. They're down by six in this game. We'll see what can happen now. We have number five, Allie Rohr, the freshman from Michigan, now to serve. Aaron Carlos with the dig. That's a little bit of a miss here. This is going to be a free ball now for the Maple Leafs. Set there for number six. Good dig there from the senior Zoe. Peyton with the set. Kristen over the top, finding the open gap. The senior Amanda unfortunately pushes it long. Kind of seemed like a dead play there on both sides. Miscommunication. There were some short balls thrown in there, long balls. Not really know what's going on. Regardless, though, that's a point for the Maple Leafs.
Just a little too much mustard on that last one from Brinkman.
Too much mustard. That's going to be a good call out of bounds there on the Bethel side. Good communication there as now Pilots are up 22-16. Katie Easter back into the game now to serve. Pilots three points away from taking this set number one. We mentioned set number one is critical for the Pilots to win this game.
Definitely. When they win the first set, they are 9-4 on the season. So that is a much better stat than when they lose it at 0-13, definitely. That's actually, if you do the math, 100% better than the other stat.
You know what, boy? I believe you are right. I don't math that good, but I believe you are correct.
Neither do I, but it's pretty simple. I think I can figure it out.
That's why we got this job here, Boyer. Number 11, Aaron Strzok up to serve now. Called out of bounds. Good call there. Another free point for the Pilot side as we now have Bridget subbing in along with Cassandra for the Pilots. They are 2 points away from taking away game number one. The true freshman, Bridget, up to serve once again.
Like we said before, she does not play like a true freshman. She has a poise about her. She's not nervous at all. She doesn't flinch in the face of upperclassmen hitting it at her. She does very well. Even the effort you saw right there on that point, diving for that ball, she shows flashes of great effort.
A little bit of miscommunication there between Zoe and Katie there on the Bethel side as we now have another serve here for number 22 for Goshen. They're down by five. They're down but not out, but it seems once again momentum is on this Pilot side. Goshen's got to take that away or this is going to go into game two as a down one. Good dig there from Katie, set from Peyton, over the top. That's that set, boy, we keep talking about. Unfortunately, though, Goshen able to deal with it well. Peyton found the open spot, but somehow it was covered up very quickly, and then a point there for Goshen, a down by four.
Definitely well received there by Goshen. They're staying on their toes a lot more. But when you're staying on your toes and you're waiting for it to happen and it doesn't happen, you have to react differently. And there's
short set there from Peyton. Huge hit from Cassandra off the hands of a Goshen player. It is now 24-19. Peyton Anderson up to serve. They are 1 point away from taking set or game number one. Short serve over the net. I don't know what the call is there, but that's game number one. Pilots win it 25-19. And boy, what were some of the keys there on the Pilot side to win that game number one?
Consistency. They were fired up throughout. They had the fire about them. They wanted to win that first set, especially for their seniors, and they stayed consistent. They communicated very well. They did what they had to do, and they came out on top. They didn't get down. They didn't flinch. And that's really what got them this win.
So this is Coach Michelle Wiegand's first year coaching the volleyball team, and we got to talk to her about her first year and what she thinks the team needs to improve on in this year.
Of learning opportunities for sure. This is a great group of young ladies. I've really enjoyed working with them. They've been very receptive to all the change. It's been a big time of transition, but I'm pleased with the progress we're making, and we're looking to continue to get better and look to have a good finish with our season.
All right, and you guys are 5-7 in Crossroads League play right now. What do you think needs to be done to finish out strong? What improvements maybe or needs to be done to finish out maybe top four?
Yeah, right now we're seated at fourth in the conference. Couple of things is really keeping my players healthy. We've had some injuries that were both ongoing and previous, so it's about getting us to be able to play at 100% for every match here on out. And that's probably the biggest thing for us right now.
You heard it there. Coach Rousseau Wiegand said one of the keys to success for coming out of this top four is going to be injuries. We've had a few injuries so far in this season. I can think off the top of my head, Haley Brown was one of the huge ones. She had a nagging injury from last season that's kind of carried on into this season. So we'll see what can happen here as the season's coming to a close. The girls got to stay healthy to continue to do this well in conference.
Definitely. And as we see now, we have received the stat sheet for the first set. And leading the team for Bethel in kills, of course, actually it's a tie between Cassandra Williams and Zoe Wolfenbarger. Very well done for both of them, five each. And then Kristen Mitchell with two, Peyton Anderson with two, and Amanda Brinkman with two as, or with one as well. And very well done. Also in the digged category, led the team by Kristen Mitchell and Katie Easter in that set. And then three with four apiece. And then three apiece for Aaron Carlos and Zoe Wolfenbarger. Very well done all together. The team effort was there. 12 assists for Peyton Anderson in that set. She was spreading the love out, as you can see, with all the different people who got kills in that set as well. Now, the blocks were not there for points, but the block shots, block hits, one for Amanda Brinkman, one for Zoe Wolfenbarger as well. Those one-on-one matchups at the net. So that was very well done for the Pilots in that first set, which resulted in a win. The Pilots are up 1-0 now.
And we did mention that stat. When they lose the first set, they're 0-13. So they go up 1-0 winning the first set, and that's huge for them statistically to go into this set number two with that 1-0 lead. So we'll see what they can do here now, as it's going to be Aaron Carlos with the serve here for the Pilots. They're up 1-0. Coming out of this brief intermission, you can definitely see on the Goshen side there's some frustration. They're not really enjoying the game right now. They just got to turn things around and start enjoying it more. Serve there from Aaron. It's a short serve over the net. Big hit there, dealt well with by Kristen Mitchell. Short set, miscommunication though. Haley Brown over the top. That's beautiful placement there from number four, Lisa Rodriguez, finding an open spot. And we mentioned before, it's not necessarily this huge hit that gets the point, but just finding the open spot.
Definitely. She got it right in that back corner. She saw what, she saw that the Bethel defense was out of place, and she got it right where she needed it to go.
We now have number 10, Christy Schwarzendruber, up again to serve for the Pilots. Aaron with a great dig there. Peyton unable to find it. Goshen now up 2-0 in set number two. Pilots have got to do something here to turn this thing around. It's only 2 points, but once again, we've noticed that momentum's got to be key. Bethel has to kill that Goshen momentum to turn this thing around. Big hit there from Amanda. Somehow kept alive from the Goshen side. Not enough to go over the net. Senior leader Amanda Brinkman coming up huge there for the Pilots.
Definitely very well done there by Amanda. The Goshen defense seemed to everyone traveled back to that ball. No one was up front to send it home, send it back over. Now we got Zoe back to serve again, see if she can pull out into a couple more aces.
Service from Zoe, dealt well with by the Goshen side. Short set, big block there from Haley and Peyton, both in the right time, right place. We mentioned blocks in the first set. Weren't necessarily a huge factor for the Pilot side, but there was a huge block from then, as it is now tied 2-2 in set number two. Senior leader Zoe Wolfenbarger once again up to serve. She's had some killer serves so far in this game.
Let's see if Vegas can pull out some pocket aces while she's serving. Definitely some kills we could have going for. There's a dig for Vegas.
Awkward point there. It's going to be a free ball for the Pilot side. Short set there for Haley, dealt well with by Goshen. Going to go deep there to Vegas. Peyton's finding an open spot. Huge dig there from the Goshen side. It's a long point there. Aaron over the net. That's a free point there for Goshen. Pushed long by the freshman. Point for Bethel and Boyer. That's a huge point there for momentum to go either way.
There, that was a very, very good rally from both sides. Saw some good things. Communicating well on both sides, but they were able to, at the end of it, Goshen just pushed it long, just a little bit long, but out nonetheless. Pilots up 3-2, Vegas looking to serve again.
We saw Zoe even right before she served, she didn't even know that they won the point. She's expecting it to be the other team's point, so just out of bounds there for the Goshen side. Big hit there, called out of bounds by the line judge. Another point for the Pilots. They're up 4-2, a little bit of a rally now for the Pilots side as they have gone up 4 points in a row. Zoe killing it with the serves. Senior leader, she's coming up huge tonight.
She's doing it in every facet of the game. Digs, kills, serves, whatever her team needs, she is doing.
That's miscommunication once again on the Goshen side. Free point. Amanda Brinkman kept alive by Aaron Carlos as the block came in there. Huge. Zoe just a touch over the net. Free point now for Goshen. Big block there. Unfortunate as it is caught between the players and the net. That's a huge point there for Goshen as we have some subs now. Number 7, McKinnon Tracy. And number 12, Lindsay McQuinn on for Goshen.
Like I said, for the Pilots, they just jumped a little bit too early on that block. It's caught in between them and the net. Unfortunate, but Goshen will take the points wherever they can get them.
Service there by McKinnon Tracy. Kind of a blown play there on the Pilot side. Just got to get it over the net. Now they got to see what they can do on defense. Number 6 there, Haley Vanetwell. Unfortunately there, she blew it, threw it in the net. That's a free point for the Pilot side. Subbing into the game for the first time now is Meg Gabbard, the sophomore transfer student. We now have Katie Easter up for the serve. Pilots are up 5-3, up 1-0. Good service from Katie. Huge hit there by number 1, Megan Gerke, the junior out of Michigan. That's a huge point for Goshen. They're down now only by 1 in set number 2.
Now back to serve for Goshen is number 5, Allie Rower. She gets it over the net clean, served by Gabbard.
Cassie Sears in the game for the first time tonight. Big block there from Cassie. Well done, the sub coming in. That's going to be a point for the Pilots. Double hit called there. Cassie Sears coming onto the court for the first time and making a huge impact as she got that block in. Well done there by Cassie. Once again, the true freshman, Bridget, up to serve. They're up by 2, 6-4 in set number 2. Short serve over the top. It's going to be a set there. Good block there from the Pilot side. Touched over the top by Peyton. That's her hit. Dealt well with by Goshen. Right into the hands of there of Katie. Cassandra with a huge hit. Good block there from the Goshen side. Kept alive from the Pilots. That's going to be a free ball now for the Maple Leafs. Big hit there from Haley Vanetveld, the sophomore out of Michigan. Once again, a big hit coming in from the Goshen side, excuse me. A big point that they definitely needed.
Definitely so much heat on it that Bethel just couldn't react to that one.
Aaron Strock to serve now for Goshen. They're down by 1 in set number 2. Bethel leads the game 1-0. Touch over the top there from Cassandra. Cheeky touch over the top. Blown play there. Number 12, Lindsay McQuinn, the true freshman out of Florida. Coming up huge there for Goshen. It's now a tied ball game, 6-6. And it seems like the Pilots are still enjoying it. They're still having fun. Typically when they get into these situations, they get down on themselves. There's some frustration, but it still seems like they're in this same game. Still loving the game, still enjoying it. Cassandra with a good touch over the top there. Dealt well with by Goshen. Big block there from the Pilots. Set for Cassie Sears, finding that spot. Good block there from Pilots once again. Peyton Anderson with that touch over the net. She's so good with finding an open hole in the Goshen defense. She just put that ball away.
Definitely. And you touched on it there. Bethel's having a lot of fun this game, and they're communicating very well. And I think that's what's translating into success. They're not taking themselves too seriously to where they're rigid. They are actually playing loose, easy, and they're communicating well. It's good volleyball, as they are now tied up 7-7. But see if Bethel can keep this momentum rolling and see if they can keep this good communication rolling as they finish out this second set, trying to go up 2-0 into the intermission.
Hit there from Zoe, the senior, called out of bounds. And that's a good call there from the Goshen side. It was out by about a yard. Zoe a little bit off there on her game, just pushing it wide just a bit as Goshen is now up 7-8. Aaron Carlos with the dig. That's going to be a free ball there for Goshen to put over the net. Touch there in the middle. Zoe finding the spot. Cassie Sears over the net. block there, but unfortunately falls on the Goshen side. Tied ball game once again, 8-8. Kristen Mitchell on to serve for the Pilots. Amanda Brinkman, your senior, once again onto the court. Amanda and Zoe being honored tonight for senior night, and they've both come up huge in this game so far.
They've had some very good performances so far, each individually.
Kept alive there by the Pilots. Free ball now coming for Goshen. Cheeky touch right over the blockers, finding an open hole in the defense. Good play there from the Goshen side.
Now back to serve for the Maple Leafs is number four, Lisa Rodriguez. Gets it over nicely.
Amanda with the backcourt set. I believe that's going to be a net violation on Zoe. That's a free point now coming for Goshen. And boy, we've mentioned a little bit these mistakes, that there weren't a whole lot of them in the first set, but Bethel needs to shy away from making those mistakes, giving Goshen free points.
Definitely, those little mental mistakes can be killers, but Zoe responds right there, bringing it home, finding that open spot and getting it right where it needs to go. That's a lot of practice that it takes to get that right where you need it to go. The accuracy, well done there from Vegas as Aaron Carlos is back to serve.
Aaron with a good serve there over the net. Pushed long there by number 10, Christy Schwarzengruber. Point now for the Pilots. It's now a tied ball game, 10-10, set number two. Your Pilots are up 1-0 in the set. Aaron Carlos with another serve. Good block there from the Pilots. Set from Peyton. Amanda with a set over the top there.
But Darian moused there for the block.
Good service there from Goshen. Set there for Zoe, the senior. Good touch there from the Goshen side. Huge block there from Haley in Vegas. Appeal for a double hit there. Haley Brown putting it away. Doesn't matter either way. Definitely an appeal there on that Pilot side for a double hit. It appeared to me it was a double hit, but Haley Brown said, I don't care whether it was a double hit or not. I'm going to put it away. That's a point for the Pilots.
Well said there, partner. Haley Brown said, I don't care what the call is. I want that point. Brings it home. Wolfenbarger back to serve again. Rare service error for Vegas. You don't see too many of those out of her, but I'm sure she'll respond. She'll come back stronger next time.
She's typically a very consistent server for your Pilots. Unfortunate service error. We now have Meg Gabber back onto the court. We've only seen her a couple times tonight, but she's usually a very solid player for the Pilots. See if she can come up big here defensively as we have number seven, McKinnon Tracy, for the serve for Goshen.
Yeah, Pilots now trail 12-11 at this point. See if they can put something together, maybe go on a run here. And that one's called in as Amanda Brinkman ties it up with that soft little hit, gets it right inside that line. Well done there from Amanda.
Seemed almost identical, just opposite sides of the court to Zoe's point a few points ago. Both seniors, once again, coming up huge. They've got to be continually to be consistent throughout this entire game for the Pilots to do well in set number two. Touch over the top there. Miscommunication from the Pilot side. A little bit of frustration you can see on Aaron and Peyton's faces as they didn't know who was going for it there. That's a point for Goshen. They're up 13-12, set number two.
Pilots need to find their footing, get that momentum on their side, because right now it's dead center. They're just pushing back and forth, trading points. They're not going to find it that way as that ball is called out. But the Pilots need to find their footing, get their back together. And Coach Wiegand calls a timeout, probably justified. They needed to kind of sit down and say, hey, let's get that fire back going. Get it going and finish this set out, come back, and hopefully go into the intermission at 2-0.
Yeah, I would say that's a smart timeout from the Pilot side. They're only down by two, but you can definitely tell there's some frustration, some lack of communication on the Pilot side. A little bit of a few mistakes that weren't critical, but it's those small mistakes we've noticed in their season that have led to the bigger moments where it's kind of put their own game away. Because they're a solid team. They have a lot of skill that we've noticed. It's just those small mistakes. They keep giving away these points, giving away these games. We'll see if they kind of turn this thing around They're only down by two. Now on the Goshen side, they're down a set to zero, but they're up by two in set number two. They're playing very well together. There's a lot of communication, a lot of talk. And it seems like they're having fun on this Goshen side too, which is definitely critical in this game.
Definitely. Coach Jim Ruth here is has a job in front of him, making sure his team stays focused, able to close it out and head to the intermission 1-1. Because there is a big difference when you go into the intermission 1-1 than 2-0. Especially when you're at Bethel, you're going 2-0. You are just one set away, one more solid set away from going home early in a 3-0 sweep. When you go in 1-1, you realize that you have two more sets. You have a lot of fighting to do coming out of the intermission. The mindset is much different. That's why Bethel needs to get it together and pull it out. Head in 2-0, sorry.
Good service there from number five, Allie Rohr. Haley Brown was there, but unable to deal with it. Zoe back on for Meg Gabbard. Not what the Pilots wanted to see coming out of that timeout. They're down by three, as it is 12-15. Goshen with the lead. Another service here from Allie. It's going to be a hit there from Vegas over the top, dealt well with by Goshen. Katie Easter there. Pilots couldn't seem to find the ball. Katie Easter with a good hit up. No Pilot to be found though now, as the Goshen Maple Leafs are up by four.
Yeah, Goshen seems to be going on a little bit of a run here. They have all the momentum on their side right now. See if they can capitalize.
Another service from Allie Rohr. Cassie Sears, the touch over the net. Going to be a free ball now. Short set. Splits the two Bethel defenders. Goshen up by five. Boy, we mentioned it in set number one. These timeouts are critical. Whoever comes out of it with the most fire, and it's been all Goshen after this timeout.
Definitely. See if Bethel can find some of that fire and close this deficit.
Cassie Sears says, I'll do it. She finds an open spot in the Goshen defense. Good hit there from Cassie. That's a point the Pilots definitely needed.
See if they can provide, Cassie provides the spark right there. Let's see if they can capitalize, get some serves together as they bring in the freshman Bridget Downs coming in to serve. She can be deadly when she's serving, so if you need a best bet in the serving game to close this gap, it would be her or Aaron Carlos.
Good play there from Bridget. Diving all over the place, unable to find that second ball. Good touch there from the Goshen side. Finding an open spot in the Bethel defense. We now have number 11, Aaron Strock, once again to serve for Goshen. They are up by five. And a bit of a substitute formality the Pilots missed out on. Haley and Bridget both off the court now for the Pilots. It's Goshen up 18-13 in set number two. Number 11, Aaron, once again for the serve. Katie Easter with the dig, set by Peyton. Cassandra with a big hit off the net. That's going to be a net violation against your Pilots. Unfortunate play there. Once again, that's going to be called against Cassie Sears.
Wolfenbarger did not like that one.
Definitely frustration now on the Bethel side. They're only down by six, but Goshen now only six away from taking away set number two. Short set over the top there from Peyton Anderson. That's the point we needed to see. We've mentioned so many times before how critical that is for her to do those short sets over the net. She's coming up huge now for the Pilots. They're only down by five in set number two. Peyton now with the serve. Over the top, a little bit of a miss hit there from the Goshen side. That's going to be a free point now for Pilots over the top. Huge hit there from the Goshen side, dealt well with by the Pilots. Touch over the top now. Unfortunately not able to find it for the Pilot side. Goshen goes up by six. That seemed kind of like a blown play on both sides of the court now, as the Goshen Maple Leafs are now within five of taking set number two.
Definitely, it was kind of a blown play on both sides, but Goshen just responded better and they come out with the point.
Peyton with the set now for Cassie. Cheeky touch over the top. Somehow finds a gap in that Goshen defense. Now Pilots within five in set number two.
See if they can get some of that fire back and kind of close this gap. There's momentum on their side as Coach Wiggins out there barking out orders.
Kristen Mitchell now with the serve, down by five. Short serve. Touch there from the senior Amanda Brinkman. Over the top now from Kristen. That's a huge hit there from Kristen. The libero on the Goshen side, not able to deal with it. You can kind of see in her face. That was just a good hit. She knows it. Nothing she can do about it there. Pilots now within four in set number two.
Very well done there for the Pilots. As you said, they're only down four now.
That's a huge hit there from number 13, Lexa Magnuson. 6-2 out of Elkhart, Indiana. Too much there for those Pilot blockers. They're now up by five, only 4 points away from taking set number two.
There's that senior experience from Magnuson. Knew exactly where to put it, knew how to get it there.
Unfortunate there, Amanda Brinkman thought she had it in there on the line. That's called out of bounds by the line judge. Huge hit there from the senior leader, Amanda, but pushed just wide now as Goshen's within three of taking set number two. Zoe with the quick hit over the top, dealt well with by that Goshen side. Krista Mitchell with the dig. Amanda's just got to throw it over the net now. Free point for Goshen. That's a missed hit there from number one, Megan Gerke, for Goshen. That's a free point for the Pilots. That was a bit of a gift there as they needed that point. They needed that to come up huge now as they're down by five in set number two.
Definitely an Aaron Carlos back to serve, and as we've said before, she leads the team in aces.
Set there for the freshman number nine, Darian Most. Just inside that line as the line judge calls that in. They're up 23-17 in game number two. Momentum is all on this Goshen side. Frustration on the side of the Pilots. They got to turn this thing around quick. Zoe with a huge hit there. No chance for the Goshen side. Zoe's telling herself, telling the team, I'm getting this thing done. This is senior night. This is her night. She's the leader. She's got to step it up. She did that there on that point.
She is putting on a show right now for us.
Vegas with the serve. Down by five. Pilots got to get a bit of a run now to stay alive. Amanda with the miss hit over the net there. She knows it. That's her bad. She's owning up to it on the team. Unfortunate. Now it seemed like the Pilots could have brought this thing around. They're now only 1 point away from giving away this set number two. They got to get a huge defensive stand now. They got to win 8 points away in a row to put this thing away.
Yeah, you said 8 points because the rule is they have to win by two. Win by at least two.
Service into the net there for number seven, McKinnon Tracy. And that's one way to do it there for the Pilots. Just let them give you some free points. They're now down by five. Kate Easter has got a huge serve here now in set number two. Good serve over the net. That's pushed wide. Aaron Carlos was there, decided to let it go, and that was a good call now. That's a timeout called now by the Goshen coach, Jim Rothier. We mentioned him a little bit before. This is his eighth season, and for Rochelle Wiegand, this being her first season, there's definitely be able to see there's a little bit of a difference as far as the coaching style and how comfortable they are with the players. This has been his eighth season with Goshen. He's had a fairly impressive record so far, 120-142 as a coach at Goshen. He's done well so far with this program, and he kind of knows how to work with it. Whereas Michelle on the other side of the Pilots, she's done well so far, but it's still her first season. There's always going to be a little bit of tension, a little bit of not knowing how to deal with it being her first season with Bethel. She's done well so far, but you can definitely see a difference in the seniority there on that Goshen side. We'll see now what the Pilots are going to do out of this timeout. They're only 4 points away, but only 1 point away from giving away set number two. We'll see what can happen now as we come out of this timeout.
As you mentioned, this is going to be a very important few sets right here for Bethel, as there is no room for error. It is set point right now for Goshen. As you see, they're loose and easy on their side. No room for error for the Pilots as Katie Easter is back to serve. As they got to close this four-point deficit, but not only close the four-point, but then add another two onto it to be able to bring this set home.
They've dug themselves quite a hole. It's not impossible, but it's going to be hard to get out of it. Frustration there from Haley Brown. She knew she was there for the block. That's going to be it for set number two as we go into this intermission. Goshen wins set number two, 25-20, and is now tied with the sets 1-1 in this game.
As we said, big difference going into the intermission with a 1-1 set score versus a 2-0. Now you know we're going to have at least two more sets on us. A lot more. It's a lot bigger mountain to climb now. Two more sets at least coming at you here on the Bethel Sports Network. Great volleyball being played on both sides at different points.
And we kind of noticed a little bit differently in set number two. There was lack of communication on the Bethel side. There was a little bit of lack of maturity, I guess, on the Bethel side as well. They made a few mistakes they didn't make in set number one. Definitely frustration on that Bethel side. We'll see if they can come out of this set number two into set number three. It's a tied ball game. We'll see what can happen now for your Pilots.
Definitely. And earlier this week, we got a chance to chat with some of the key players from Bethel. And we asked what the team needs to do to win more games. We've kind of seen it. We've seen lack of mental mistakes, narrow it down, things like that. But let's see what they had to say about it.
To improve the most, I would say our defense, because at the beginning it was offense, and now we've started to generate more kills. And since then, I feel like we need more work on blocking and defense syncing up together. And then I feel like once those two things, once we get everything on defense-wise all lined up, I think that everything will just mesh and we'll gel and we'll be able to start strong, finish strong, and be able to be consistent throughout the rest of these games.
Yeah, for me, I think a big thing that would be good for our team to improve on is our consistency. We have these moments of greatness, and then we have these moments of just not greatness. So if we can be great all the time, that would help us a lot, I think.
Mine kind of goes along with Haley's. It's more so with starting strong and ending strong. We have moments where we start really strong, we don't end as strong, or sometimes we go all the way through. But basically what a team pushes back on us to like challenge them and push through it.
I think as a hitter, it's your responsibility to hit the ball and be able to find kills no matter how good or bad the set is. It's your duty as a hitter. And also to know that it's not always about being strong and powerful. It's about where you put the ball and sometimes being working smarter, not harder. And I would just say that I think a great relationship with your setter, like constant feedback, like you got me, I got you. Like if that was a bad set, I'll get it over. But that was a great set, that last one. Like just constant communication probably.
Nice. And then for you too. What would you say the most consistent or the best part of your game is, or what needs improvement most as well?
I think there's always room for improvement. Some nights I have a great blocking night, and other nights my hitting's on. So I think, you know, just being able to have a consistent blocking night with a consistent hitting night would be something that I can work towards.
Yeah, I feel like there's always, again, room for improvement. I think it's important for a player, whether position they are, to understand that, I mean, you don't have to be perfect all the time. Volleyball is a game of mistakes. But to know that if you do feel off, to put that work and effort in, and if you need those extra reps, go ahead and put it in the court and come in early for practice.
Realistically, I see us 100% capable of beating every team we play. So I expect to either be fourth or third, second at that. And then I expect us to win the conference championship.
I completely agree. If we can put that consistency together and just continue to improve every game, there's not a team that I can see us not being able to beat in the end is if we pull together and, again, with the consistency of our play.
Because we know our potential and we've seen it, and basically it's just getting it out there on the court every day and making sure, again, consistent.
Every game we have, it's not like it's like, oh, they're definitely going to beat them, or they're definitely, like, every single one of our games, it's not like we can show up not ready to play, because we have to be ready to play every single game, because like we can battle and we can fight, and we just have to pull out the W at the end. I've always tried to lead by example, but this year I've been trying to be more vocal about things and just setting the standard as to what we expect in the gym and what we expect like attitude-wise and effort-wise, not necessarily like doing it right or wrong, but like just giving it 100% all the time. So I don't know, I would say that just setting up expectations so that when I do leave, we have like a high standard set.
And you heard it there from some leaders on the team. Two of the key things I noticed from that interview is, one, the defensive side. We've talked about a little bit in this game so far. Defensively, it seems like the Pilots have been able to find those huge blocks that they've needed, the huge things that they've needed. And then the huge word that I found from that, and we've seen over the entire season, is consistency. The Pilots, as Haley Brown said, they have moments of greatness, and they have moments where they're playing really well and they're doing really well together. Then they have moments of they're playing not so great and they're kind of falling down mentally. So if we can kind of see that coming into set number three, where they can be consistent, even finishing out the season consistently, it'll be definitely a huge thing for the Pilots side.
Definitely. And something else we saw in that little interview, Zoe Wolfenbarger, she said it. She is confident. Every team that comes into Goodman Gym or wherever they go there, she is 100% confident that Bethel can beat that team. So they're confident. They can come in, win every game throughout, win a conference championship, and that is what the goal is, she says. The standard is very high. The bar is high. They will take no less.
And I wouldn't say that it's a false confidence either. I think that you can have sometimes with sports players, with teams, they get asked in this interview, yeah, we can win this national championship, we can win conference, but I truly believe with this Pilots team, they have the skills. We've talked about it before. They have some incredible athletes on this team with incredible skill sets, and they just haven't quite put it together as an entire season. They've had moments of brilliance in individual games. They've had moments of failure in individual games. They've had some mental relapses, and they've had some great plays together. So it kind of, the huge thing for me is just what Haley and Aaron kind of focused on was that consistency. If the Pilots can continue to be consistent throughout this season, I think they can go far, especially in the tournament, even make it on a nationals. I think that's the key to the success, is consistency for the Bethel Pilots.
You said it best, folks. That was very well said by Justin. And it is. It's the big word. It's the word of the day. It seems to be the word of every day in Bethel volleyball. Consistency. Now, what you need to see is that every set, every point, you're able to communicate well. Get the serve over the net. Get the setter. Get it to the setter. Everything you need to do, all those little things can be big things when done wrong. And when you have that consistency, you can do all the little things right every single time. That makes you dangerous. And we can see that from the Pilots. They can definitely beat any team that they meet. As the Pilots are getting ready to come back out now onto the court for the last round, the next sets after the intermission.
So we'll see what the Pilots can do coming into set number three. It's tied 1-1 with Goshen. And Bori, what do you think Coach Rochelle Weekend was telling the Pilots in that intermission? What do you think she was kind of focusing on, other than what we've touched on defensively and consistency? What do you think that Coach Rochelle was telling her players in that intermission?
I think first things first, she said, hey, it's senior night. I'm sure she probably had Zoe and Amanda stand up and say, you're playing for them. This is a big night. They don't want to lose. You don't want to lose. Do it for them. Do it for a win on not just at Goodman Gymnasium, which their record at Goodman this season is not amazing. It's 2-9. But to get that win on senior night is so important. It means so much to these girls. They put in hours upon hours of work, and they can do it. It's not out of reach. It's not an unattainable goal to beat this team. Goshen is not a super team by any stretch of the imagination. And even coming out in the first set, they prove that they can do it. It can be done. They can put it together. They can go on a run, and they can take a set. Now, they kind of fell off a little bit, lost the intensity that they had in the first set and the second set, and it really came back to bite them. So I guess the main thing would be stay consistent and be able to come out with that fire that they had in the first set.
We have now some stats from set number two. Definitely sharing the love now, as we have for kills. Cassie Sears led the team with three and then tied at two. We have Zoe, Peyton, and Amanda, and Haley Brown and Krista Mitchell each with one kill apiece. From the Goshen side, there are kills all the way around, as we have Megan Gerke and Haley Vanetvel each with three kills apiece. We have Darian Mouse, Lindsay McQuinn, and Alexa Magnuson with two. And then Allie Rohr, Chris Schwarzenbacher, and Lisa Rodriguez, all with one kill apiece. So there's definitely not really been one or two leaders in the kill statistics on either side of the team. So we definitely have seen both teams sharing the love, giving the ball to different players, and we'll see what they can do now as we come into set number three. You see the girls huddled up there in the middle. They're having fun. They're having a good time. We have Zoe out there, the senior leader. She's got to come up huge in set number three to put this thing away.
Definitely. And you said they have a good lineup on the court right now with Zoe, Cassandra Williams, Christian Mitchell, Peyton Anderson, Katie Easter, and Haley Brown down there in the back row. Definitely a good setup, a good nucleus to be able to get some points, go on a run early in this third set and bring it home. Actually, Haley Brown coming off the court now, and in comes Aaron Carlos. Doesn't hurt the team at all. That is a good trade out. Aaron, of course, does her best work in the digs department as she does lead the team and in aces.
Well, we will see what happens now. As we're about to get the action started. Once again, we have number four, Lisa Rodriguez, with the serve. Set number three on its way. That's called inbounds there. Huge hit from the Bethel side. That's exactly the start they wanted into set number three.
Yep, way to set the tone there from Cassandra.
We now have our second senior, Amanda Brinkman, onto the court now. She and Vegas have got to lead this team to victory.
They've been coming up big tonight. They see if they can get it. Coming into that second set, that's a point for Goshen there. But like we said, Amanda and Zoe have to propel this team to victory, and they are doing a fantastic job so far. They just need to stay consistent and bring it home for the Pilots.
Coach is not too happy with that last call on the Bethel side. They wanted that to be their point. They didn't think they touched it. That's a double hit now called against Bethel. And now two early mistakes for Bethel, leading to Goshen being up 2-1. Service here by number 10, Christy Swartz and Druber for Goshen. Set there from Peyton. That's got to be touched over the net. Unfortunate there for Amanda. Set just a tad out of a reach. Not able to put it over the top. And boy, we talked about it. They got to come out strong or it's not going their way.
Definitely, it's 3-1 now. They can't dig themselves into that deep of a hole again. Like they learned in that second set, that if the hole gets too insurmountable, it just gets too rough. And that one is pushed wide.
Short set there for Cassandra, trying to find that back spot. Appeals for a touch on the Bethel side. Judges having none of it there. Now as Goshen is up 4-1, set number three, Pilots need to turn this thing around. Good dig there from Aaron. Unfortunate, a little bit too long.
They're calling a net violation on Peyton Anderson for that one.
Timeout now from Michelle Wiegand. That's a smart timeout. She is not happy with this Pilot side as they came out of that intermission flat-footed. They're lacking momentum, lacking energy that they had in that set number one and even set number two. And just look at frustration now on the Pilot side. Now, Rochelle, she's just got to tell, hey, you guys got this game. Once again, we talked about they're not outmatched by any means. They have the skills. They just got to put it together with a consistent game in set number three.
Definitely. And something that's interesting in this timeout is usually when you see Bethel take a timeout, Rochelle Wiegand, she talks to an assistant coach for a second, lets the team leaders go in and say their piece before Rochelle goes in. This time, as soon as that timeout is called, sits everybody down, she is right in. She had something to say, and she wanted to be heard in that timeout. They are down 5-1 right now. This is not the start they wanted coming out of the intermission. And Coach Wiegand's reminding them, this is it. This is for your seniors. It's not just about you. It's about the team and coming out and getting a victory, which you've proven you can do, but you're not playing like it. I don't need to see it out of you.
Huge hit there from Vegas. That's blocked out of bounds, but saved there from the Goshen side. A huge block by number 14, Cassandra Williams. That's exactly what they needed coming out of the timeout. She's all smiles. Haley Brown now into the game for the Pilots. Service now by Erin Carlos. We mentioned her before. She is the team leader in aces. She's got a heck of a serve. That's going to be a free ball now for the Pilots over the net. Set for Peyton. Amanda Brinkman, the senior, with a huge hit. Vegas is getting the girls going. She knows this is exactly what they needed to come out of that timeout. That's 2 points in a row now for Bethel. They're only down by two, set number three.
And Aaron Carlos back to serve again.
Good service there from Aaron. Good block. That's off the net and out of bounds. Appeal for a touch from the Goshen side. Not going to get it, as that's going to be a Bethel Pilots point. Aaron Carlos once again with the serve. That is 3 points in a way for your Pilots. Definitely what they needed to come out of this timeout for the Pilots side.
Doing very well coming out of the timeout. And Aaron Carlos able to chase that one down.
Krista Mitchell back over the net. Well done from Aaron Carlos. The freshman with a huge hit. Not enough, though, as your Pilots were there for the block. We mentioned it in the time or in the intermission, the defensive side. They got to come up huge with these blocks. That's exactly what they did there. It's a tied ball game.
Coming out of that timeout. It was a good timeout by Coach Wiegand. They closed the gap right away. They did what they had to do. And that's another ace for Aaron Carlos. Add that to the total. She has now 17 on the season. Very well done from Aaron. She can pick her spots. She does it well. She mixes it up with those barely over the net serves, and then the line drives like you see. Very well done there from Carlos. Just couldn't get it on the get the dig right there.
Pilots had three up to block for that. Goshen able to find their way around it. It's tie ball game 6-6, but definitely what the Pilots needed out of this timeout. Doing very well now as it is a tied ball game. We have number 7, McKinnon Tracy, the sophomore out of New Carlisle, Indiana, up to serve for Goshen. It is tied 1-1 with the sets. We are in set number 3, tie ball game at 6. Haley Brown with the killer hit there. Well done from Haley. Huge point there for the Pilots, their first lead of the set.
Brought that one home with some authority.
Definitely what they needed. We have our senior leader, Zoe, up to serve once again. And consistency with her serves is what she's definitely needed so far.
Vegas has been lights out this game in every facet of the game.
Good block there from the Pilots. Short set over the net. Peyton Anderson once again. We've said it a million times this season, a million times tonight. That's exactly her hit. That's what she needs to do to get her team some points.
She loves to do it. She does it well and comes out right more often than not.
Zoe once again with the serve. Good serve there. Dealt well with by the Maple Leafs. That's a missed hit there from number 6, Haley Vannevelt. We've seen a few out of her tonight. She seems to be a little off. Unfortunate there for the Goshen side. That's a free point for Bethel. Timeout now for Goshen. That's definitely what Bethel needed. As Goshen now seems, they found themselves on the bottom now, down by 3, 9-6 in set number 3. Boyer, what was the change there out of that timeout? What change? It seems like the team's kind of flip-flopped in the game so far. What changed in this set?
Bethel got it together, they got the fire, and right now in Bethel's huddle, you see the freshman, Bridget Downs, talking. She has a little bit more of a voice, but you saw it. They had the fire. They were playing for each other. They were playing together. They talked. They did what they had to do. And they got the points now. It is 6-9, and Bethel is up. And it's very nice to see they communicate, and they're having fun again. I think the one thing that you saw in the first set, more than the second set, was they were having a lot more fun. They were a lot more loose. And when they started to get down, they kind of got more frustrated. And when you get frustrated, you make mistakes. And that's what you saw in the second set. But now they're coming out again. They're loose. They're easygoing. They're having a good time. I think that has really been the difference for the Pilots. See if they can come out and keep that fire going and take home this set.
Couldn't agree more there, Andrew Boyer, as Zoe keeps the serve. They're up 9-6 in set number 3. We'll see what can happen now as she is up for the serve. Huge serve there, pushed just wide. Good call there from Goshen to leave that out of bounds. Couple subs coming in now. We have number 5 and number 13. That's Allie Rohr and Lexa Magnuson. Lexa, the 6'2 girl out of Elkhart. See if she can come up huge now on the defensive side for Bethel. Service there for Goshen. Amanda with a touch over the net. Good touch there from Goshen side. That's going to be a Bethel point. Double hit called against Goshen. Free point there for the Pilots. We've talked about this mistake, kind of having these simple mistakes, and so far it's been all Goshen having those mistakes in set number 3. Pilots now up by 3, 10-7.
Katie Easter with the service error into the net. Not what they're looking for to keep momentum on their side.
As soon as I said they weren't making mistakes, there is a mistake right there. That's classic commentating, jinxing it, man. Unlucky. We now have Aaron Strock up to serve for Goshen. Vegas with a dig, Peyton with the set, Haley with the kill. good hit there from Goshen. Over the net by Goshen. The blockers were there. It seemed kind of like a botched play, unfortunate play there for Bethel. Goshen now within one in set number three. That's the hit we wanted to see from Peyton, but unfortunately she goes into the net. And we mentioned it before, Boyer, it's these simple mistakes. Pilots now had three of them in this set number three. They got to get rid of those to stay in this game. It's tie ball game, 10-all.
Definitely need to lock that down. You don't see that very often from Peyton, though. Those quick sets over, and that one is ruled in. Well done there for the Pilots. But back to Peyton. She always does those little quick sets over the net. Normally it comes out with points, but everyone making simple mistakes here. We have Wolfenbarger get the serve into the net, which you don't see from her very often. Now you just saw Peyton get her signature move into the net. See if they can come back and lock down these mental errors. And that's a point for Goshen.
Unfortunate play there for Zoe. Bridget came on for the serve. She's now coming right back off as Haley Brown is coming on for your Bethel Pilots. It's now a tied ball game, 11-11. In set number three, it's tied a set apiece. We'll see what the Pilots can do now defensively. Returning the serve, Katie there with the dig. It's gotta be Zoe over the net. Unfortunate there for Katie. She was in the right spot, right time, just a little too much for her to deal with there. Pilots now down by one. Goshen with the serve.
Too much heat on it there for Katie to handle.
A little too much mustard there, Boyer. It's going to be some, okay, 15. Something called against Zoe there. That's going to be a point for the Pilots. Maybe she was out of bounds when they served. I'm not sure what the call is going to be there, but that's a point for Goshen. Cassandra with a huge hit there. Good block there from the Goshen side. Miscommunication from the Pilots. Free point now for Goshen.
Double hit called on Goshen there. Costly mistake.
Pilots now within one. The score being 12-13. Peyton up with the serve in this set number three. Good service there from Peyton. Touch over the net. Aaron in the right spot. Set there from Peyton. Cassandra with the block there coming against her. Zoe's got to go over the net. Free ball now for Goshen. Miscommunication on both sides of the net. That's got to go over now for the Pilots. Good hit there from Kristen Mitchell. Good dig from Katie Easter. This is a long rally now. Kristen Mitchell putting it away right into the face of number five, Allie Rohr. Unable to deal with it now. We have a tied ball game at 13 apiece.
That was a great rally for the Pilots. Definitely a confidence booster as they go through. Momentum's on their side now as Anderson gets that serve over. Well done.
Got to be over the net now for Kristen Mitchell. She's been very consistent so far tonight. Peyton in the right spot, right time. Big hit here from Zoe, the senior. Somehow kept alive over the net now for Goshen. Free point for Bethel. Kristen Mitchell out of bounds, unlucky there. I don't know how Goshen kept that one alive, but they did, and that's a point for them.
That was just hustle. That was a great effort play from Goshen. You had to hand it to them. They covered that very well. They didn't give up on it, and they managed to come out with the point. Well done.
Lisa Rodriguez with the serve once again. Short set there. Cassandra Williams right in the face of Lisa, unable to deal with it. We got Amanda Brinkman, one of the seniors tonight, once again onto the court. Katie Easter coming out. Kristen Mitchell with the serve. We have a tied ball game, 14-14 in set number three. Huge block there from Amanda and Cassandra. This is going to be a free point now for your Pilots. That's going to be called against the Pilots. That's a double hit. Once again, Bor, it's these simple mistakes we've been talking about, not good for the Pilots.
And if you're listening to this stream and you're like, oh, what? You're getting tired of us talking about the simple mistakes, just quit making the mistakes. It's every single game, it seems. Every set we see one just like right there with the Brinkman. If it wasn't such a common thing, we wouldn't talk about it. But it is every game and every set, there's always a couple. There's always a few mental mistakes that need to be ironed out.
And it goes back to that word we've talked about, consistency. There's just been a lack of it throughout this entire season. And even as we see in this set number three, I was pushed wide there by the Pilots. But yeah, it's just been a lack of consistency. These simple mistakes not helping the Pilots. Amanda with a touch over the net. Going to be a free ball now for Goshen. Krista Mitchell, right spot, right time. Zoe with the big hit there. Good dig from the Goshen side. Krista Mitchell with another good dig. Appeals for a double hit from the Goshen side. Not going to get it. That's pushed long from Amanda Brinkman. It seemed like a good play there from the Pilots. Rochelle Wiegand now with a timeout. They're only down by four. Not out of the game by any means. But definitely they're down, definitely they're feeling it, a little bit of frustration. We'll see what can happen now as we come out of this timeout. Goshen definitely feeling it. They're up by four. The set is tied 1-1 in set number three. Boyer, what does Bethel need to do to come out of this timeout strong?
They were showing it originally. They were showing that consistency, and they were showing that they can do this. But now the mental mistakes have been kicking in. We've been talking about it. They have not been ironing out the things they need to iron out, those hits into that, the missed time jumps, things that can be ironed out in practice. And I think that's what Coach Wiegand's saying to them right now. You can't lose this one. It has to be, you gotta have that energy. You have to have that competitive fire. They're just not showing it right now. They started out, but they're kind of starting to fizzle out. And fizzle out there, Goshen can go on a run. They're happy now. But Goshen has gone on a little bit of a run here. And coming out now, they seem a little more fired up. See if they can come out and put some points on the board. On the court right now for the Pilots is Zoe Wolfenbarger, Peyton Anderson, number 14, Cassandra Williams, number 1, Aaron Carlos, Kristen Mitchell, and Amanda Brinkman. Never mind. Cassie Sears coming out now for the Pilots. See if they can generate some points.
Number 10, Christy Swartzendruber with the serve for Goshen. They're up by four, set number three. Touch over the net there. Zoe thought she had the point. Goshen coming out of nowhere now. That's unfortunate there for the Pilot side. Aaron and Kristen looking at each other, not sure whether to call that in or out. They called it out. It was in. That's a point for Goshen.
Just able to touch that line. I would have called that out too if I were Aaron. It's a judgment call at that point.
Big hit there from Cassie. Too much for Goshen to deal with. That's the point they needed. Now within four as Haley Brown comes onto the court.
Haley Brown comes off for Cassandra Williams, helping out that front line. And back to serve again for the Pilots is Aaron Carlos. She's libero. She does very well with the serves, as we've talked about.
Good service there from Aaron. Good dig there from Kristen Mitchell. Peyton with the set. Cassie's got to go over. Just over the net. Somehow kept alive from Goshen. The freshman there hit it into the net. I don't know how they did that one, but Goshen well played there. Just not enough. Cassie with a huge hit there just over the net. Pilots now within three.
16-19 now is the score. Like you said, Pilots only down three. And Aaron is a very good server. She has the opportunity to lead them into this.
That's called out of bounds by Kristen Mitchell. She knows it was a minor mistake, but it's a costly one. That's a point for Goshen now as we have some subs coming in. For the Goshen side, it's going to be number 7, McKinnon Tracy, the sophomore out of New Carlisle, Indiana, up to serve. They're only 5 points away from going up 2-1 in this game. 4 points over your Bethel College Pilots.
Yeah, Carlos received the serve very well there. And
Zoe with the big hit there. Well done. That's going to be a carry called against the Goshen Maple Leafs. That's a point now for Bethel. Down only by three with a very good and a very confident server now out of Zoe Wolfenbarger. Serving now for the Pilots. Only down by three. They got to string some points along together now to stay in this game. Blockers were there. That's over the net now. That's a touch over the top from Peyton. That's what we wanted to see. Somehow the Maple Leafs able to keep that alive. That's a free point now for Bethel. Haley Brown with the kill. That's pushed just long. She's a little frustrated there. She knew she had that point. Just a little too much mustard on that one, Boyer.
A little too much mustard. No one likes too much mustard. It's
That'll
just
get you every time.
It will. Just right outside that line. As Allie Rohrer, the freshman, is there to serve for Goshen. As they are 4 points away from taking this set, making it 2-1.
Cassie Sears with the awkward hit off the hand. Somehow finds the back corner now for Cassie. That's a good point there. Pilots needed that one. Katie Easter now onto the court for your Bethel College Pilots, down by three.
It's definitely not unattainable at this point for the Pilots. As that serve hits Alexa Magnuson in the face.
A little miscommunication there from the Pilot side. Off the net, off a player. No one there, though, to recover that one for the Pilots. As they are now down by four, we have number 11, Aaron Strock, up to serve, 3 points away from taking set number three. Kristen Mitchell with a huge hit there. That's unfortunate. Hits off the rafters of Goodman Gymnasium. Little home court advantage there. That's a point now for the Pilots. They're down by three. Cassandra now onto the court. We have Bridget, the true freshman, once again up to serve. She's been very consistent so far in this game. See what she can do now as the Pilots are down by three. That's a miscommunication there. Somehow almost kept alive there, but a double hit called against Goshen. Pilots now down by two as a timeout is called from the Goshen side. Frustration now on the Goshen team. Definitely a little bit of laughter, some smiles all around on this Pilot side. They're only down by two.
Definitely. There's that fire we were talking about. They came out, they brought it back, they had it, they have it still. They're talking, they're smiling over there on their sideline. And it's very good. See, as you can see, Britton Carnahan, she's firing them up a little bit. They have it. They have it right now. They have all the momentum on their side. They're down by two. It's not insurmountable. All they need is string a couple of points together, and they are right in it. And they put the work in. They put the effort in to be able to bring it home. They just have to do it now. They just have to execute the way they know how to execute, play their game, bring it home now so they can go up 2-1.
Only 2 points away now from tying this game. Pilots are fired up in this timeout. They want this for sure. We mentioned it before. It is senior night honoring Zoe Wolfenbarger and Amanda Brinkman. They got more to play for than just this game. They're playing for their seniors. They definitely want to win this one for them. Both seniors have been very critical so far in this game, coming up with some huge points, definitely some senior leadership from the Pilot side. We have Bridget up to serve. They're only down by two. They need these next few points to stay in this set.
The very crucial points, and not what they needed to see there from Bridget Downs. That was just too much to handle. Slightly out of position, but it was enough to get her.
Frustration definitely from Bridget there. She was in the right spot, just not able to deal with it.
Maybe that was just an inexperienced thing right there, but either way. Too much on it there for Cassandra Williams. Now what they need to see is now set point down by four. Pilot seems to be a little bit self-destruction going on as it is set point.
Give me a back court hit there from Zoe. Dealt well with by the Goshen defense. That's put away for Goshen. They take set number three. The score being 25-20. Your Pilots are now down 2-1 in this game. Not looking terrible, but not looking great there for the Pilots. It seemed like they definitely had the ability to win that set number three, but that's an unfortunate play there from the Pilots side. So, as we've mentioned before, this Bethel volleyball team has only two seniors. So, they have a lot of players coming back next year. We asked Coach Wiegand about the senior leadership this year. So, go ahead and take a listen.
It was about midpoint through our season where they really kind of pulled the senior card. And they're like, this is it for us. This is our last go around. And they really got the team to come around. And feel like, hey, what is our legacy here? What are we leaving behind? And they got the youngsters to get on board with them. And that's really made a difference in our team with their attitude, their perspective, the amount of focus and effort they give in the practice gym. So that's been really key for us. And I'm going to continue to look to them to get our team on board and our mindset in the right place.
You heard Coach Wiegand say it there. Their seniors kind of stepped up halfway through the season. They decided, hey, I want this game. I got to turn this thing around. We got to step it up. And so we've definitely seen that in this game. The seniors have done very well so far in this game. They've been very consistent, coming up huge, both offensively and defensively, and really just having that communication and that leadership kind of aura around them. They've done very well so far in this game. Unfortunate, though, as they are now down 2-1 in this game. So we'll see what they can do coming out of this intermission now.
As they are crowding around Amanda Brinkman right now, emotions building over the Pilot sideline as they're praying. It is very difficult to play this game. Very difficult. She is a senior. This is her last go around. This is senior night. And it is tough to be down as much as they're down. It is tough to work so hard and get so little out of it so far. And now she is begging, pleading with her team, you got to come through. This is for me. This is for Zoe. This is for the aspirations we have and the goals we've set as a team. Everything has got to be on the line right now. You got to put that work in and help us out. We can't do it by ourselves. We need you. And there is a sisterhood. It is a sorority kind of deal. They are a family. And when you're in a family, you can show emotion around your family. You can show how you really feel. You can tell them what you're really thinking. And it's not a problem. It's not an issue. You can come to them and say, do it for me. Help me out. I need help. I can't do it myself. And that's what's going on here. They're trying. Zoe and Amanda are putting on a heck of a show tonight. But they can't do it alone. It has to be a full team effort. And now you see during that little intermission, see if that can light a fire underneath these Lady Pilots.
We'll see what happens now as we are in set number 4. As the Goshen Maple Leafs are up in the set count 2-1. If they win this one, it's all over. If they lose this one, we'll go to a set 5. So we'll see what can happen now as we do have the stats for set number 3 from Andrew Boyd.
Yep, the stats that we see for Bethel, leading the team in kills for that set was Cassie Sears and Kristen Mitchell, both with 3. 2 for Cassandra Williams, and then Amanda Brinkman, Peyton Anderson, and Haley Brown with 1 apiece. And you saw it, and the blocking game showed up a little bit more. 2 blocks for the team as the Amanda Brinkman and Haley Brown each had 1. Aaron Carlos to serve. We'll give you more stats in the next intermission.
Huge hit there from Goshen to set off this set number 4. Snuck just inside the line. They go up 1-0.
And going back to what we saw during that intermission from Amanda Brinkman, there was some emotion pouring out because Bethel, just be realistic, Bethel is one set away from losing on senior night.
Set there from Haley Brown. Big kill dealt well with by Goshen. Kept alive somehow. Good dig there from Kristen Mitchell. It's got to be over now from Kristen. Could have gone long there, but kept alive from Goshen. That's into the net once again by number 6. Unfortunate there for Haley Vannenvelt. But Kristen Mitchell coming up huge with that dig. No idea how she kept that one alive and then getting a huge hit over the net. Once again, she's been very consistent so far in this game. Our senior leader, Zoe Wolfenbarger, now up to serve.
She has been dynamite from that server position today.
Short set there over the net. Zoe from the backcourt. Good hit there, kept alive by the freshman. Kristen once again there. That's that hit there from Peyton Anderson. But Goshen was ready for it. Peyton kept alive. Got to be over now from Cassie Sears. Finding an open spot. Huge rally now for both teams. See what they can do with it. The Pilots with a free ball now. Cassie with another huge hit. Good block there from the Goshen side. Short touch over the top. Cassie kept alive. She's now over the net. That's a point for Bethel. Haley Brown's loving it. That was huge there for the Bethel College momentum, Boyer.
Definitely. Haley went up for that one-on-one matchup at the net. Darian Most was there, freshman for Goshen, but just too much to handle. Haley Brown wanted it more, wins the one-on-one matchup, brings the point home for the Pilots as Wolfenbarger sets it over. And another rare service error for Zoe Wolfenbarger. She takes credit for it, she says, my bad, but taking accountability doesn't take the point back. They gotta respond now. It's 2-2.
Unfortunately, once again for Zoe, we now have number 7, McKenna Tracy, up to serve for Goshen. It's tied 2-2. That's unfortunate for Krista Mitchell. She's been very consistent this entire game, but a rare error once again there from Mitchell. It's now 3-2 Goshen. In set number 4, they lead the game 2-1.
Yep, 2-1. If Goshen can come out this one, we are going back home, folks.
Service there from McKinnon. Got to be over now from Zoe. Another one into the net. You can tell right there on her face. She's frustrated. She knows that's on her. She's a senior leader. She's got to step it up. She's got to lead this team to victory for sure now. McKinnon once again with the serve. Goshen on a little bit of a run. See, Pilots can turn this thing around. Good touch there from Haley. Almost kept alive from the Goshen side. That's a huge hustle play. Not enough, though. That's a point for the Pilots.
That's what they needed to get back into it. Just one point at a time.
Katie Easter now subbing on for your Pilots. She's up to serve. Down by 1, set number 4. Good service from Katie. Good hit there from Haley Brown. That was a short set coming in from Peyton, and Haley able to put that one away, find the hole in the Goshen defense.
Well, then it looked like Peyton was gonna do one of those little short sets that she always likes to do over the net, but really it was deceptive. Set over to Haley, well done there.
Haley and Peyton with a huge block there, a brick wall, that's pushed over the net there. Katie kept it alive. Now with Krista Mitchell, she pushed it long. Unfortunate there. Peyton and Haley coming up huge with a couple of blocks there, but unfortunate there as Kristen Mitchell pushes it just a tad long. Goshen up by 1.
Just way too much mustard on that one for Mitchell.
That'll get you every time, Boyer. Too much mustard.
Oh yeah, it's like they were trying to pour the mustard onto a hot dog and the cap fell off.
That's not good now, but that's a free point for Bethel as number 5, Allie Rohr, serves into the net. Mistake there from the Goshen side. We now have the true freshman, Bridget, back onto the court for your Bethel College Pilots with the serve. Good block there from Bethel, kept alive by Katie Easter. Zoe over the net, free point for the Maple Leafs, but that's a good hit there. Unfortunate, Katie Easter knew it. She had that ball, but unfortunately pushed just over ahead. Bridget coming off the court as Haley Brown is subbing back on. Service now by number 11, Aaron Strock. The Maple Leafs are up by 1 in set number 4. Blown play there, but somehow kept alive by the Pilots. Zoe Wolfenbarger with a big hit there. That's miscommunication there between Aaron and Zoe. Once again, you can tell it on their faces. They're frustrated. Good spot there from the Goshen side.
As the score is now 7-5, Bethel's only down 2, but if Goshen's able to go on a run, we might be going home earlier, folks.
Krista Mitchell with a huge hit, kept alive by Goshen. This is going to be a free ball now for your Bethel Pilots. Short set there. Big hit from Cassandra Williams. Pilots now within 1 as Peyton goes back to serve.
Cassandra's all smiles after that one. Looking at Coach, pulling up the 1.
Good service there from Peyton. Huge hit there by number 13, Lexa Magnuson, the senior, the 6'2 senior. That's a lot of force coming down on that ball. That was a huge hit there. The Pilots not able to deal with it.
Yep, as you said, Lexa is 6'2 out of Elkhart, Indiana. It's right nearby.
Kristen with a cheeky touch. That's going to be unfortunate there with the fourth hit. Not touched from the Goshen side. Tristan wanting the cheeky touch over the net. Not enough on it. Kind of died on the net there as we have Goshen up to serve. They are up by three, set number four. Good touch there from Cassandra. She does it all. She's got the huge kills, and then she's got the short touches, finding an open hole in that defense. Well done from Cassandra.
Cassandra finds the motivation. Now that's her second kill of the match. She looks at Coach, says, that's two. Coach Wiegand responds. Coach is like what she sees out of Cassandra Williams.
That's a huge hit there by Christy Swartzen-Druber, the junior out of Nebraska, finding the open hole in the Bethel defense. Goshen up by three.
Now back to serve for Goshen is number four, Lisa Rodriguez. As Aaron Carlos chooses to serve very well.
Good hit there from Vegas. That's a good dig from the Goshen side. That's going to be pushed out of bounds by number 10, Christy Swartzen-Druber. Pilots within two. Haley Brown comes on for Cassandra. Aaron Carlos back to serve. Good service there from Aaron. That's unfortunate for Kristen Mitchell. She was there, pushed just over top of the blockers there out of Cassie and Haley. Unfortunate for the Bethel side. So Michelle Wiegand's going to be calling a timeout now in set number four. They're only down by three, but the Pilots definitely seeing some frustration on their side. Goshen doing very well so far, being very consistent, limiting the mistakes. Boyer, what does Bethel have to do out of this timeout to turn this thing around?
They got to get the fire back. It's really, Cassandra's showing a very good intensity coming out of this, into this set. She's doing very well, but it's not being reciprocated by her teammates. I think that's the conversation going on right now. We got to get back. It can't be all just one. So Coach Wiegand's coming in now. They got to get that fire. They got to keep the momentum on their side. And once they can do that, they can close this gap, bring it home, and go into a fifth set.
Couldn't agree more there, Boyer. We'll see what can happen now as we come out of this timeout. And we've mentioned it a few times tonight already, but whoever comes out of the timeout with more energy, with more fire, typically is the one that kind of goes on those runs. So we'll see if the Pilots can be motivated enough out of this timeout. It seems like they're loving it. They're having a little bit of energy there. So we'll see what the Pilots can do now as we come out of this timeout. Got to come up huge on defense, though, to win back this serve. Goshen's up by three. Number 10, Christy Swartzen-Druber now for the serve for the Maple Leafs.
That is a last name, folks.
It's a last name and a half, Boyer. Christy with the serve. Cassie Sears with the hit. She found the open spot, but she pushed it just wide. Now that's a point for Goshen. They're up by four, 12-8. Set number four. Big hit from Zoe. Haley Brown kept it alive somehow. But that's going to be a point for Goshen. They're up by five now in set number four.
Pushed out wide, and now Bethel is quite literally 12 points away from losing on senior night. And I know Zoe Wolfenbarger does not want to see that happen. She's trying with all her might to get it done. And Krista Mitchell, great effort there.
Krista Mitchell has been playing very well in this game so far. It's got to be over the net now for Zoe. Somehow she's kept it alive a few times tonight. Krista Mitchell unable to come up with it there now. Is not that what we wanted to see coming out of this timeout for the Bethel Pilots. They're now down by six in set number four. Solid serves coming out of Christy now for the Maple Leafs. Set number four, Goshen's up 2-1 in this match. Over the top there for Cassie, good hit there. Huge hit, somehow off the shoulder of Aaron, kept alive. Zoe over the top, Kristen Mitchell keeps it alive. Short set there, kept alive off the foot of Zoe Wolfenbarger. Unbelievable play from the senior. And somehow Goshen gets that point. That was incredible from Zoe. Somehow Haley Brown goes off the net. Zoe keeps it alive with her foot. But somehow Goshen gets that point. Very unfortunate for Bethel.
Good effort there from Zoe, thinking with her feet. Just couldn't get it off the net there. Could Peyton Anderson and Haley Brown. That's hurt as Goshen has doubled up the Pilots, 16-8. It is not looking good right now for the Pilots. Coach Wiegand's got to find some fire in her girls, or else a loss on senior night is very, very possible.
Another timeout called by Coach Wiegand. They got to turn this thing around. They played very well in the first couple of sets, and it seems as though as we get into this set number four, something's kind of changed. They've had these small mental errors that have not been doing a whole lot for them on this side. They've been giving some free points to the Goshen team, and as we've mentioned before, if they give away those free points, they make those mistakes. It's just not good for the Bethel side because they have the skills. They have incredible athletes on their team, but unfortunately just being very inconsistent tonight, and that's not what we need to see out of them.
It adds up. Those mental mistakes adds up. It is a point for the other team every time you make a mistake, and it is coming through. Goshen, don't take anything away from Goshen. They're playing well. They're playing solid volleyball, but Bethel is also shooting themselves in the foot. It seems more and more often as the game goes on as they get more frustrated, which is not helpful by any stretch of the imagination.
Goshen now only 9 points away from taking away this entire game. Bethel's got to come up huge and push this to a set number five. Cheeky touch over the top there from Zoe, dealt well with by the Goshen side. Aaron with the pancake, not enough on that one. That's another point for Goshen. They're now up 17-8, up by nine, a mere 8 points away from taking away set number four. Short set there by Peyton Anderson. Good hit there from Haley Brown. Appeal for a touch, not gonna get it. That's a point for Bethel. Good play there from the Bethel side, calling that one out of bounds and leaving it.
Good vision as Wolfenbarger back to serve, hoping she can get the team back into this.
Find the open spot. Aaron Carlos kept that one alive. Zoe now with the hit. Incredible play there from Aaron. Huge block from Peyton Anderson. Well done there from the Pilot side. Zoe kept it alive somehow. Cassie Sears over the net. That's pushed wide, out of bounds. Point for your Pilots. That's a huge play there from the defensive side of Bethel. No idea how it happened, but that's a point for Bethel. That's 2 points in a row, Boyer.
Sometimes it's better to be lucky than good. You take those points wherever you can get them. That'll flip the momentum for Bethel and see if they can keep it rolling, get on a run here and close this gap. They are down seven as Wolfenbarger puts it over.
Short set over the net. Bethel was ready for it. Zoe over the net. Free point now. There we go. Good touch over the top from Haley. This is now going to be a free ball for the Bethel side. Peyton finding an open spot. Haley over the net. Now another free ball coming for the Bethel side. Haley with the big hit there. Rodriguez dealt well with it. That's going to be over the net now. Good touch there from Peyton. Cassie Sears with a big hit straight into the brick wall. That is number nine and number one, Darian and Megan of the Goshen side. That's a huge block there for Goshen. They're now up by eight, 18-10 in set number four. We have once again McKinnon Tracy, the sophomore, up to serve for Goshen.
We are 7 points away from this one being done and in the books for Goshen. See if Bethel will be able to close this gap, go on a run. Haley Brown trying it there.
That's pushed long and out of bounds by McKinnon Tracy. That's a point for Bethel. They are down but not out. They just got to believe in themselves here. Have a little energy, a little momentum now as Katie Easter comes onto the court for the sub. We now have number five, Britton Carnahan, coming onto the court. She's not seen a whole lot of time tonight. See if she can be the difference this Bethel College Pilots team needs to turn this set around.
Yeah, but you haven't seen much of Britton Carnahan tonight. See if she can be the spark that the Pilots need to close this gap, but a service error is not what's going to get them there, that is for sure.
Bethel is definitely not out of this game. They can't, but they just can't give these points away to Goshen. They got to make any point that Goshen's going to get, they got to make him earn it. And that is unfortunate there. Boy, you said it. Sometimes it's better to be lucky than good, and that was 100% lucky there from the Goshen side. The Pilots now down by 9. Michelle Wiegand still believes in him, clapping him on, cheering for it. The Pilots just have to believe themselves here. They're down by 9, set number 4. Meg Gabbard with the set over the net there. Good touch there from Mitchell. Brayton with the hit. That's going to be long and out of bounds. Goshen's now up 21-11.
Too much muster on that one for Brenton Carnahan. I think we're going to make that a catchphrase for me.
I probably can make that a catchphrase, Boar. I'm down for that.
Too much mustard on that one.
Allie Rohr with the serve. Meg Gabbard the dig. Haley Brown with the point that they so desperately needed. They're down by 9, but not out. Bridget coming on along with Cassandra for the Pilots. They got to do something different. They're down by 9. They're 4 points away from giving this game away. See if they can do something now. It's Bridget, the true freshman, on the serve. Huge hit there from the Goshen side. Unfortunately, finding that it just inside the corner. That's going to be a point for Goshen. They're 3 points away from taking this fourth set.
3 points away from taking the game as well.
That's a service error from the Goshen side. Throwing points back and forth to each other. Let's see now what Britton can do. Or sorry, Peyton Anderson can do for the serve now for your Pilots. Huge hit there, but that's going to be a violation of the pole, I believe. I don't know what it's called. That's a point for Pilots. They're now up, they're now down by 8 in set number 4. Boyer, you know what that's called? I don't know what it's called.
I
couldn't tell you. That's a point. Doesn't matter how they got it. Good hit there from Zoe. Another point now. Zoe over the top. That's a huge hit there from Zoe. She believes in her team. She knows this game is not over yet. They're only down by 7. Timeout now called from the Goshen side. Pilots are coming up huge, Boyer. It's not over yet.
Definitely is not over yet. It is still 3 points for Goshen, and Bethel has to close this out. The fire is there. It's senior night. You need to show that fire, especially for Zoe and Amanda. Do it for them because they are the heart and soul of this team. They have done very well. They put in those hours and hours in practice, motivating this team, getting them together, getting them to really, really push forward and focus. And really, they have to do it for them because it is, like we said, it's senior night. It is a very bad night. You do not want to lose. If there were any games that you would never want to lose, you never want to lose a game, obviously. But the ones that you never, ever want to lose. Senior night, homecoming, games like that. And right now, with a couple of mistakes or a couple of points, Goshen could take the heart right out of this Bethel team losing on senior night.
But fortunately, it seems like the Pilots definitely believe in themselves. They're not out of this yet. You can see them coming out of this timeout with their heads kind of held down, but they're definitely still in this. There's high fives all around. There's smiles all around. They believe in themselves. Zoe's got to come up huge now. Their leadership definitely has got to shine as they're down by 7. If they give 3 points away, Goshen will take it all. So we'll see now what Bethel can do. That's a free point now for Bethel. Cassandra hitting it in there now. It's going to be a free point for Goshen. They got to go over the net. Huge hit there, just out of the arm reach of Katie Easter. She was there, but touched out of bounds. 2 points away now from taking the game.
Pilots now looking to make this score respectable as they try as they might to close this gap. Momentum is all in the favor of Goshen.
Britton with the huge hit, somehow kept alive by Goshen. Free ball now for Pilots. Zoe with the cheeky touch over the middle, finding that gap. Freshman now with a touch over the top. Aaron keeps it alive. Britton with the set. Wolfenbarger, another huge block there from the Goshen side. That front line is doing incredible things now in this set, number 4. Huge hit there. This is a huge rally now for both teams. Britton trying to find that back corner, not enough. Blocked there once again from the Pilots. Britton with the set. Zoe with the huge hit there, somehow kept alive once again. And that's going to be called out of bounds against Goshen now. That's a point for the Pilots. That was a long point and a point that the Pilots so desperately needed. Krista Mitchell back onto the court along with Cassie Sears. They're only 7 points behind Goshen. They're down the series 2-1. If they let this one slip by, the game will be over as Goshen will be winning 3-1. Krista Mitchell with the serve, though. It's not over yet.
But definitely.
That's unfortunate. That was touched early on by the blockers, again by Peyton, just out of the reach of Krista Mitchell.
Now there is absolutely no room for error from the Pilots. Any error, game over.
Cassie Sears finds it over the net now. Touch over the top. Peyton keeps it alive. Cassie's got to go over. As you mentioned before, no mistakes now from the Bethel side. Kept alive there by the hand of Peyton. Pilots hanging on. That's going to do it, folks. As number 10 for Goshen, and that's going to be Christy Swartzen-Druber, puts it away. That's game over, folks. Unfortunate there as the Goshen Maple Leafs are going to win the series 3-1. Pilots came out strong but couldn't quite finish well.
Yeah, that one's heartbreaker for the Pilots. As you can see them kind of hanging their heads going down. They really put their heart and soul into that one, but just too many mistakes, too many little things going on. Just couldn't bring it out with a win. So you saw it. It was kind of more of a, it was a little back and forth at times, but Goshen had it pretty handedly throughout. Anything, Justin?
Thank you once again, though, for tuning in on the Bethel Sports Network. If you want to tune in once again, Wednesday night, October 26th at 7 p.m., once again here in Goodman Gymnasium, you're going to see your Bethel Pilots face Spring Arbor in another Crossroads League matchup. Would love to hear you tune in on the Bethel Sports Network. But as for Andrew Boer, I'm Justin Brown, signing off.